Hello and welcome to New Mexico's Naturopathic Medical Show. I'm Dr. Wendy Vandilla, naturopathic physician and your host. In the studio today with me is my beloved holistic dentist, Yeva Wright. She's been on the set with us twice before, and that was a couple years ago, so I'm delighted to have her back. Thank you for coming back on the show, Yeva.
You're so welcome. I'm happy to be here.
And we've got some updating to do. This show is entitled Applied Kinesiology in Dental Diagnosis. So we'll talk to Yeva about what the heck applied kinesiology is, a little bit of the history, and how she uses it in her practice.
That's right. Hi. Okay. So applied kinesiology. Probably most people have heard that term, you know. It also goes muscle testing. But basically, what it is a way to test structural balances in the body, chemical balances, material testing. It can be used in many ways. The history, it started actually with chiropractic. Mm-hmm. In chiropractic, I think, and I can't quite remember the gentleman's name, but it's been around a while, and they started noticing that structural balances could be created and could be checked if you tested using muscle testing. And in dentistry, it's extremely helpful because you can test structural balances in the body. You can check your bite, the bite after you created a crown. You can do, you can also material testing people who are very sensitive.
Now, and the connection between chiropractics and dental isn't obvious to probably a lot of our viewers.
Right, exactly. I mean, it came through the structural. In other words, structural balancing, when chiropractors would be adjusting the body and structurally balancing it, mm-hmm. That's all of a sudden where we as dentists, when we were checking bites and we were checking TMJ, you know, the jaw temporal mandibular joint problems, all of a sudden there we could use this as another tool. I mean, it's a tool. Right. It's not the only thing that you should be using, but it is a wonderful tool to use. Now, we should probably talk a little bit, you know, I mean, it does look a little bit like voodoo when you're doing it. I mean, you know, people are going, what is the dentist doing, you know, with this? And I think, I always say to patients that if you can believe in acupuncture, this is not so crazy. It's basically what it is that the body has an energetic connection, and all the meridians are flowing, then there's a connection. And that's what acupuncture basically does with the needles, to try mm-hmm. to get that flow to happen. What kinesiology does, because muscle is such an electric organ, mm-hmm. what kinesiology does is basically you test this interference. Is there an interference in this electrical energy patterns?
And the teeth are part of that
energetic
patterning.
And the teeth are part of it, exactly. So, and you, what's called, you therapy localized to the area, and you see like a circuitry. In other words, you hold that area where you want to test on the body. If you're testing materials, you can test them, again, on the body in different parts, and you can also even put it in the mouth if necessary and test. And when I say testing, as a dentist, I mean, the chiropractors can use I could use any muscle, really, to test. Once I get a baseline on a muscle, I can go ahead and test it. I use the arm, because that's mm-hmm. natural in a dental chair. Usually the patient is a little back, so when I use this arm here, and down the line we'll demonstrate maybe if we can
yes,
a little bit.
Absolutely.
You'll be my guinea pig.
Yay.
And we can kind of take a look and see what exactly, you know, how does it look.
And it's quick.
It's very quick. It's very quick, very practical to do, you know. So that's kind of I've used it probably, my gosh, I've used it probably about 30 years now, because I had a wonderful chiropractor in Chicago that we started working with, and she was an applied kinesiologist, and so she kind of introduced me to it, and we took some courses together with David Walters in Colorado in the 80s, where it kind of brought the science, because I needed the science behind mm-hmm. it. I can't just, you know, have little crystals walking around me and go, oh, this works. You know, so it was good for me to have that, to actually have that demonstrated, how if you adjust the hips, the bite changes. If you change the bite, the hips can be out. This connection, that was my introduction in a way to the connection, of structural connection of the body. So.
Well, yeah, that's a very important part, that there's a lot of different systems that you deal with. I mean, our immune system, the type of food we eat, the bone, yeah. the nervous system.
Yeah, yeah. Structural, muscle. Chemical, exactly.
In sinus, nose, breathing.
Exactly.
Like brain a function, famous thing. Ears, tinnitus.
That's
oh
right.
Oh my gosh.
Exactly.
There's so much going on.
It's like a gyroscope for the body, this whole area here. You know, everything is going on there. So, because as you know, for instance, let's say a patient comes in with a toothache. This would be a good place to kind of see how kinesiology would work. They come in with a toothache. It's not, the x-ray doesn't show too much, maybe a little irritation, nothing. Patient has symptoms, the toothache sensitive to cold, pressure, what could it be? That's where kinesiology is helpful because you could test, is it the tooth? Is it the nerve of the tooth? Is it the filling? Is it the sinus? Because if it's an upper tooth, and it's pushing, the sinus is pushing against the tooth, people will swear it's the tooth, and there's, you know, something wrong with that tooth, and there's nothing wrong with the tooth.
The tooth is just getting mushed on.
Exactly.
Pushed on.
And applied kinesiology by therapy localizing to the different areas, it'll differentiate. So that's where kind of things, you know, it's another tool to use. Because the x-ray is not going to show you much. The symptoms of the patient, when they tell you what their symptoms are, you know, you can listen, but it's not also going to be very definitive because it can be many things. It could be a cracked tooth, it could be cracked filling, you know, all kinds of things. So it's another help.
Yeah, one thing I find with patients is they have an idea of what's going on, and sometimes they're right, mm-hmm. and sometimes they're not right.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But they're convinced mm-hmm. that this is the way to explain it. So a mm-hmm. lot of times I have to just say, well, tell me what's going on. How
exactly.
does it feel?
Exactly.
You know, give me the symptoms.
Exactly.
Not your diagnosis.
Exactly. That's exactly what I do, too. And I listen, listen, listen.
What are some of the trip-ups of kinesio, of
very
applied kinesiology?
Good. Very good point. So, because it's an energetic tool, basically you're dealing with the electromagnetic energy of the body, and we know we can change that a little bit. So if you're going to train yourself to do applied kinesiology, mm-hmm. you almost kind of have to become like a robot. Your intention cannot be in there when you're testing, because your intention and the patient's intention could actually change it. And, you know, that kinesiology sometimes has become a little bit like a parlor game. And I always say to patients, okay, well, try this parlor game and see how it can change. Group of you, sit in a room, pick one, and test their strength in their arm. Just test it any way you want. Have them go out of the room. Then all of you go, okay, now, when he or she comes back, their arm will weaken. And come and test again.
And it'll happen.
It'll happen. Because the energy, the strength of that. So that's where kinesiology in some ways has gotten a bad name. Because, you know, if that is interfering, mm-hmm. you can't really trust the results. So, you know, if you're going to use it, you have to kind of, since I've been doing it for so long, I've kind of literally learned to become a little bit like a robot. I'm not there.
Not be attached to
I'm
the
not
outcome.
Attached to the
you
outcome.
Can change the outcome.
Exactly. I'm not attached to the outcome. I'm just there. You know, when one of the courses I took years ago, I remember the gentleman actually had a little pressure gauge that he used to show that exactly the same he's pressing the arm, not sometimes stronger, not sometimes weaker, that it's exactly the same, and that he would just practically look away and not care.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I thought, yeah, that makes sense. You can't be in there. So yeah, I think that's a very good point to bring up because a lot of people say, well, kinesiology doesn't really work. They tested me, and those supplements were that way, and you know,
mm-hmm.
so yeah.
So you have to be. You have to train yourself.
You have to train yourself. You have to be very.
I've always wondered. I mean, when you're holding a bottle of a supplement.
Mm-hmm.
And you're testing, I mean, what are you testing for? Is mm-hmm. it the plastic? Is
energetic. It? The energetic of that. It's best to have this, it's more accurate to have the sample itself. The bottle will work, but again, it's one step removed, you know.
So it will interfere with.
Yeah, it can interfere. But so best thing is always just the sample itself, you know, if you can, as close to the sample. Sometimes when I'm testing dental materials, I'll even actually have them put it under the tongue. And sometimes, especially people who are very environmentally sensitive, I'll make up a little packet with little samples for them
mm-hmm.
and take it home and kind of wear it on your body, wear it in your mouth, hold it in your hand. Then a week or two later, let's retest. Because sometimes, you know, they'll be okay in the beginning, but as they're more exposed because of their sensitivities in their bodies, you know, sensitivity, it's not okay.
Well, this is an area that I think you really excel at, is fine-tuning treatments and diagnosis to people that are scared and chemically sensitive and been traumatized by other dental experiences.
Yeah, exactly. And like I said, it's a good tool, it's not the only tool. I mean, there are blood tests that you can do, let's say, for testing materials, dental materials. There's blood testing you can send it, I think it's Clifford. Mm-hmm. Remember that? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And they'll send you a bio. They take a sample of blood, you send it in, and they'll test like 1,500 products. Mm-hmm. So it's a help. It's like a Bible that you can start with what the patient is. But I find the body is just too dynamic.
It changes.
So it's a good baseline, but $350 for a test.
Shows a snapshot of what's going on. Right. And it may be irrelevant by the time you're actually working with the person.
So I work with those. Sure, but you know, and we often will do that test in conjunction. I still do the kinesiology because I think it lets us know now, or even that day, what anesthetic can I use?
Well, that's
the anesthetics.
Yeah. I mean, that's another thing I appreciate about you, Eva, is that you combine a bunch of different. You use science, you use energetics, you use herbal medicine, you use conventional medicine.
Mm-hmm.
You're very
that way. I'm a great believer in a holistic approach. You know,
use what works, take advantage of all these
all
different
of them.
Things.
They all have a place. It's just that people start to get sometimes a little bit, you know, narrow in one direction, and that's it, that's all there is, and nothing else. So I think,
So I will show me.
Let's do a demonstration.
Do it.
Right, exactly. Usually in a dental chair, you know, it's kind of easy because you're lying back. The idea is to try to isolate as much like one or two muscles that are working, that it's not the whole, you know, because then it's harder because the muscles all are, you know, working in a big group, and it's harder to be as precise. So you try to like, I don't do it this way because a person can use these muscles to hold it up and I can't get the feel. So this way actually I find is easier. So that's what I'm going to do on you. Now, excuse me, we have some wires that we have to be very careful about.
Yes, we can
do
it.
And it might look a little clumsy when I do this, but here we go.
There. We got it.
There you go. And I can let that hang right here, right?
Yes.
Okay. All right, so what I usually do is, so I have you like that.
Should I take my ring off?
No, because what we're going to do is people say, well, you have jewelry on, should I take my jewelry off? I said, no, I'll just get a baseline first. Then I know what that baseline feels like. Then from that, the differential is what I'll know, you know. So first what I'll do is I'll say resist. I'll push in this direction and you resist me. There. Now take a deep breath in and out. And that's just for clearing, just to clear it. Resist. Good. Then I do something to check what's called, and we're going to get a little bit involved, it was what's called neurological switching. In other words, we want to make sure that there isn't some, some nerve patterns that are really interfering. Mm-hmm. In a quick way, and it does seem very weird to do it, is a polarity change. I go here and I test you, then I change the polarity, which is I change my fingers like this and retest again. And when I do that, I won't tell you what I expect because then I don't want you to know. Resist, resist, and then resist, and there you go. And that's normal. That's a polarity change. That means you're normal. I can test you. I can trust it, you know. So, okay. So, resist.
It's like short-circuiting.
It's short-circuiting, exactly. Another way would be like right here.
Are some people cross-wired and you got to figure
exactly,
that out?
Exactly. When they're cross-wired, then they'll be all over the place. They're not, you can't trust that energy pattern because they're strong, they're weak, whatever, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You can supposedly quickly undo it by taking these little points and rubbing them like crazy. If someone is, you know, a little screwed up, to put it scientifically. Okay, so now let's see. So we're going to do a little bit of structural testing, okay? So we'll do like your TMJ stuff a little bit, check your sinuses a little bit, and I'll show. So it's kind of like therapy localizing. So here we go. Resist, okay. then I want to complete the circuit and see if that circuit is working. So you go ahead and put your fingers right here by your jaw joint, you know where the TMJ joint is, exactly. And jaw relaxed, don't touch your teeth together, so we, there you go, very good. Now clench your teeth, resist. Not bad. A person who has a little TMJ problems and they bite down, they will weaken. Yeah. And now let's check your muscles.
Or if a bite's off,
if the bite is off, exactly.
Okay, the muscle, like a facial muscle?
Yep, the masseter. Mm-hmm, that little masseter, you know, when the clenching muscle, right there. Resist. Now clench one more time.
Oops, I was clenching.
That's okay, both, because I think you're fine either way. Resist. Yeah, you're fine.
Oh, I got a neck adjustment.
There we go. Now, now let's test your, relax the jaw. Now we're going to test her sinuses. And what I do first is, actually, you don't even have to do that this time. I go like this. It's an activation point. Resist. And there you go.
It's still there. No surprise.
Resist. There you go. So sinuses are a little bit. Now let's check that tooth up in the back. You know, your weak tooth. Uh-huh. Which you go inside your mouth and you place your finger on the tooth. Resist. Good. Go up above it. Remember we treated it. Mm-hmm. Resist. And it's doing fine. Hold it there. Now you want, as the patient says, well, you know, it's still hurting. So you go, okay, we've tested the tooth, we've tested the root, now mm-hmm. let's test, is the sinus involved? And your sinus is a little involved there. Mm-hmm. So sometimes that tooth could act a little weird, but it's not the tooth, you know. So that's kind of quick structure. You can also check bites, for instance, resist. So you take a little one of those, everyone's gone to the dentist and has a little paper taken and you go like this and you
chew
go like
on
this.
It and then
yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, the regular dentist would basically just go ahead and then adjust where he saw the spot. Mm-hmm. What we can do is also, yeah, see a spot, but then we would test that. And I don't have a dental instrument and I would have you open and I would place the instrument on that spot that I saw as high and test. If it's too high, it will weaken. Now a general bite down. And take your finger and just place it like you're checking the bite, top and bottom. Now she's checking the upper and lower teeth, so resist, fine. Now go in the back, the last, I'm going to check that last tooth in the back, biting down again, resist. In a little bit there, we might have to look at the bite on that tooth. You saw that difference, there's a little bit. Mm-hmm. So that's kind of just a quick about structural testing. Now let's see about materials.
And structural testing means how
means
the
teeth are working together
the
with the body joint, exactly.
So
are your teeth interfering?
Bones and muscles.
Exactly. You can even tell things like, for instance, people have neck problems, okay? Jaw relaxed. And you can say, check, okay, is the bite interfering? Is the bite part of the neck problem? So let's say, okay, jaw relaxed. And you activate it here, good. Good. Now clench. Resist. No, little bit maybe. A little bit. Notice that I wasn't pushing hard, but a little bit. It wasn't like you were sinking.
Yeah.
So it could be that your bite, so that would be a person where you would think, well, let's test you for a little splint to wear. That helps balance
relax
this.
The
exactly. Mind. And also when you go to your chiropractic or your acupuncture adjustment to or cranial, sacrocranial person, that they would wear that splint while they're doing the adjustment. The neck will hold better. That's where those connections are when we talk about, you know, biological dentistry, whatever. That's the connection, is that it really is the whole body working.
How about somebody that has ringing in the ears or headaches?
Yeah. There is tinnitus.
The
bite can very much. I have, in my 47 years, I have helped with tinnitus a lot. Always to look at the dental aspect of it. It's not always. Sometimes good old tinnitus is this weird thing where the nerves just have gone bonkers, you know, scientifically, and they just don't seem to work. But definitely always look at the structural part of it, because do you remember how this is set up? I'll sit down and then we can do a little more testing later. So I'm not standing here. There you go. Do you remember, what was I going to just say? I was going to say something.
Tinnitus.
Oh, yes, about tinnitus. The structure is, remember, the condyle sits in that wonderful little fossa. The ear canal is right behind.
So it's like a cup and a ball.
Mm-hmm.
The two.
And so the ear canal is right behind. So if this little cut, little ball is a little pushed back
the
in here,
ear?
The ear canal, the Eustachian tube. The okay. Eustachian tube is right behind there. That little opening is right behind, if you look, right behind. So if this is pushed in a little bit, the ear canal is affected.
And that drains the middle ear.
And then you get tinnitus. And if you can take the pressure off and get the blood supply, then how do you get the pressure off? A little splint. What does a splint do when you put something in between teeth at the right height? When you're testing again with a kinesiology, what do you get? You get space.
And then your body's stronger, and it tells you that.
Exactly, and that's about the height, too, you know. Just to put something between your teeth is not, people say, well, I'll go to the drugstore, and why should I be paying, you know, $400, $500, $600 for this thing when I can get something for $25? Well, it's the height that's so important. Is it 1 millimeter, millimeter and a quarter? To where do you test the strongest? You know, and that we could do a TMJ show. I just realized, just on that alone. because then we could show a little bit, like adding on a little bit of wax. You know, 1 millimeter, you weaken. Millimeter and a half, millimeters, you're strong. 3 millimeters, you weaken. That's how specific the height has to be. So just putting something between your teeth.
That's not the point.
It's not going to work. Yeah.
It's a specialized.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So in the position of where you're putting it to get that space open, to get the blood supply back in there and all that. Kinesiology, again, helps because it can make it very specific. Now, let's see.
Well, another way you use kinesiology, I know, is to test somebody's sensitivity to the different dental materials.
Exactly. Exactly.
And there's a lot of different dental materials that you work with.
Exactly. Just because it's a tooth-colored filling doesn't mean that every patient is okay with it. There are these MSD sheets that they send, supposedly they give us all the, but there's some grandfather clauses in the whole, in the industry, so not everything is listed. They don't have to list everything.
And so, what might be perfectly safe for one patient,
exactly,
another patient's
exactly
energetically doesn't do well.
Energetically does not, maybe chemically too, you know, whatever level, it's not working for them. So I test. I test all the materials. I brought some. I'm going to test you a little bit on some of it. And we brought some sugar. And I wanted.
I'll be curious.
Yes.
And then we've got some OSHA soaked.
Great. And that is the
which
one
is
for
a natural.
Yes.
Type of sugar.
Yes. That's great. Yeah, we will test that too. Let's do that.
Okay.
Let's do it now.
Sounds great.
I'm going to come again with my wires here. There you go. Okay. So let's actually go ahead. Let's do that. Yeah. Now this is in a jar, but I'm not so worried about, you know, it will still come through, you know, energetically. So what I'm going to do again, we go back to your, to get you to in baseline, resist. Okay, that's good. Then go ahead. First, just hold it right across. I always try to get it in different parts energetically in the body. One here, one in here, and one in that chakra right there. Resist. Good. Go ahead, put it in your tummy area. Resist. Good. Then in your forehead. Good. And on the side even. Now that seems like a good material for you. I mean, it would someplace show up. Now let's go ahead and try that.
Okay, so this is actually a raw sugar, natural sugar.
Resist. Put it on your stomach.
I'm not trying to do this.
I know you can fight me. Go ahead, fight me.
This is good for me. This is really good for me.
I have in my 47 years never found anyone who's okay with sugar.
With sugar, oh my gosh.
Raw or whatever. Honey, sometimes okay, you know, but sugar, like that kind of sugar.
Well, this is a raw, unrefined honey.
I know.
Which is.
Well, that one is okay
right,
with you.
Right.
But, you know, sugar cane, and put it on your forehead too. Let's
okay, now
check.
This is really good for me. It's
yes.
It's really, really good for
resist.
Me.
Resist? Yes.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm trying to resist.
I always tell kids and sugar, when I, you know, I say to them, okay, well, let's test you. Can have sugar. No
and
one can have
can
sugar.
Any kid.
I don't
yeah,
that.
Exactly. Let's see what would be more interesting go ahead.
Some commercial honeys are often cooked and often have high fructose corn syrup added.
There you go.
So it might that be, will, yeah. might not be the yeah. honey that, yeah. that's testing
that's
bad.
exactly. And you could then get fancy and take the parts, you know, get fructose, sea fructose, just pure honey. You know, you could do all kinds of stuff, you know, get fancier mm-hmm. with that.
Well, but as using this technique, you've got to be clear.
Very
and not
clear.
Be attached to the
very
outcome.
Clear. Very clear. Exactly. Yeah. You have to. Like I said, the best image I have is
yeah,
a bit
minutes.
Like a robot, like a robot. You know, where I just simply
just
am there, but I'm not. I used to, when I was younger, I used to actually have like a little image of a curtain falling in front of me. You know, whatever image you want to use. But you
well,
have
that's
to be
like a meditative skill to
yes.
be able to be
yes.
detached from
yeah.
your preferences.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's why I think allopathic, our regular medicine, has such a hard time with it. Because, you know, they want black and white. They want it, you know, okay.
They want a machine to do it.
Machine to do it, exactly. And maybe some machine could be developed to do it. It wouldn't be bad to have a machine that actually, because there aren't there some like Vegas, some of those machines mm-hmm. that you can put samples mm-hmm. on and they
yeah.
test,
yes.
right?
Oh, yeah.
Well,
yeah.
you know.
But the advantage for you is that you're right there with the person
exactly.
and you can do it quickly and get information.
Exactly. Like patients don't have, in my practice, patients don't have trouble with anesthetic. You
yeah.
hear about local anesthetic that people afterwards have, oh, I'm so, you know, I'm so out of it for days. Well, it probably was that it was epinephrine in it, and most patients don't do well
with it. Yeah, I know. I don't test
yeah.
well with epinephrine.
Yeah.
And
so
lidocaine.
There you are. You just quickly test the little carpules, which one today. And sometimes that will even change. Like I've had, let's say I've used one isocane, which is like, seems to be a good, strong one, but people don't do well with it. I still, the environmentally sensitive patients, I will go ahead and test them. You know, the day that of the day of the work.
Mm-hmm.
Are we still okay with this, or do we need to go to Citanes? Do we need? There's many on the market now. You know, you have many choices.
That's so personalized.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah. So, and patients don't have trouble. You know, afterwards they don't have trouble.
Well, plus, they feel like you care about them.
Yes.
Of course. That's one reason I keep
Absolutely.
Going.
Absolutely.
Well, this has been fantastic to get the demonstration. We'll continue talking, and we're at the end of this segment, but we got another one coming up.
Good.
So this is, I've been talking with Dr. Yeva Wright, who has a private holistic dental practice here in Santa Fe. Thank you to Harvey and Dottie again for operating cameras. Thank you for George for directing. You've been watching New Mexico's Naturopathic Medical Show. Tune in again, and thank you for watching. Mm-hmm.